Welcome to today's edition of the show podcast.
Now, this episode is usually a hit or miss on RuPaul's Drag Race. Yes, you'll get your standout comedy queens, but there is always that cringe disaster that makes me want to turn my TV off and never watch anything again. To make matters worse, there was no in-studio audience beyond the judges and the Miss Congeniality queens Heidi N Closet, Nina West and Valentina, due to the coronavirus pandemic. There was no runway this week either, so let's jump into each of the competitors' performances. Candy Muse. Candy has come a long way since the start of the season. She has this fiery, lovable attitude that has really brought out the best in her. In my opinion, she is the main character and nothing is going to stop her. Candy's growth in the competition has finally got her claiming her first ever main challenge win. As Candy was born and raised in NYC, it's obvious she could kill it on the mic and outshine anyone. The energy she emits fills the entire room, and her personality alone got her on the top. The jokes landed every time, and yes, Candy may have used a body-shaming joke, but it was funny, and she's plus-size herself. She also chose to open the show, which was a very clever move on her part. Simone, unfortunately, was second after Candy. While Candy is growing in strengths, Simone is showing more and more weaknesses. She gets too much in her head, and that reflects poorly. We all know she is excellent, but once that inner demon comes into play, she fails. In the roast, she totally bombs, and we can't help but feel sorry for her. The episode edit sets up an interesting look at how Gottmik, who was dreading the roast, overcame her fears but emphasizes how Simone is stuck in her old ways and can't come out of it. Utica. This episode was the downfall for Utica, and it went down in crashing flames. I can see why she was kept around so long, because she is truly intriguing. She has an eye for fashion but then is terrified of being offensive, so makes an afro out of squirrels but then comes out with some hard-hitting reads about her fellow queens. Truly intriguing. Utica is funny, but when she tried to really go for it, she failed hard every time. I mean, you can come out with funny jokes, but to stand there and fat shame Michelle Visage and Lonnie Love on the judging panel was a delusional move, at best. Gottmik. I am obsessed with Gottmik, she is a true comedy queen. I mean, she won Snatch Game, that says it all. Although she didn't get top place in this episode, she was in the top three, and that it is just pure victory, especially after she doubts herself. The judges love her to death, and that all they have is praise for her, which is well and truly deserved. She is a triple threat, and while Simone is her biggest competition, it looks like Gottmik may now be the front runner of the pack. Olivia Luxury. There was a time at the start of the season, and I would have told you, hands down, Olivia would win this season. But the last episode has not been good for her. As Ross Matthews said, she is one note, and it's getting really boring. If she goes out next episode, I would not be shocked. This roast, she decided to play the OMG I'm a really nice character that doesn't say anything bad, but oops you smell. OMG I can't believe I said that. It did not work, and the nice girl is flat, and I just cannot stand it. She landed a few jokes, but they were not amazing. If it was not for Utica crashing, she would have been in the bottom. Rose started the season off as a background character. Have you seen the sequence of her dancing in the back of each lip sync? She literally was a background character, but she fast-tracked her way into the top. Rose is confident with her onstage persona, and she can kill the entire competition with her roasting ability. Her jokes were funny, and she was not afraid to outshine, but as Lonnie said, she was better in the rehearsal. She is forced to be reckoned with, and I think we will see her in the top three. The results. Simone and Utica placed bottom. We knew it would be an interesting one to watch, as neither are strangers to a lip sync. They both gave it their all, but didn't pull out any surprising moves, resulting in a mesmerizing Simone getting to stick around for another week. The top four is just one more elimination away, and this means it's only a few weeks before we'll have our season 13 winner. Who do you think it will be? RuPaul's Drag Race season 13 continues Saturdays in the UK, exclusive to Netflix.